Sustainability is the central goal of the Queensland Sustainable Fisheries Strategy. The most important question for fisheries managers is how many fish can be taken before fishing becomes unsustainable. A sustainable population simply means a group of fish that is able to sustain itself year after year. Fish reproduce and replenish their numbers to replace those lost to predators, disease, or aging. But if too many fish are lost, for example from fishing pressure, that group of fish may not be able to replenish its numbers year after year. We first need to define what we mean by a population of fish, which is a group of fish that breed. This is referred to as a fish stock. We need to look at what makes a fish stock able to breed and replenish itself. Scientists monitor the number of females and males, their size and age, and the number of juvenile fish. Environmental factors are also important, such as nursery habitat and prompts for breeding, such as river flow and temperature. To ensure a fish stock is sustainable, we look at how much biomass there is compared to how much would have been there prior to fishing commencing. This is sometimes referred to as virgin biomass or unfished biomass. To know what is the right level of biomass, we need to choose a benchmark or reference point. The most important goal is sustainability. Fish stocks must be healthy enough to replenish themselves. Usually, a fish stock needs to be about 30 to 40% of unfished biomass to remain sustainable. The minimum biomass required for sustainability is known as maximum sustainable yield. The level of biomass required for optimal fishing efficiency is called maximum economic yield. An even better benchmark is the level of stock needed to optimise efficient fishing. Putting more effort into fishing doesn't always mean catching more fish. Up to a certain point, if you put in more effort, you'll get higher rewards. But when there aren't enough fish available, it becomes increasingly hard to catch them. Putting in more effort doesn't necessarily mean higher rewards. The ideal is to get the best rate of return on your effort, the most bang for your buck. This ideal rate of return is possible when larger amounts of fish are available. In general, this requires about 60% of unfished biomass. So how do we make sure we stay at these levels? Harvest strategies help ensure fisheries are managed sustainably by setting out what actions should be taken, depending on how the stock is tracking against benchmarks like these. A number of controls on fishing can be applied, like changing quotas and bag limits, or other actions like size limits or seasonal closures. To keep up to date on the Sustainable Fisheries Strategy, visit our website.